Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on setting up Apple Social Login for your BuddyBoss web and app. We'll show you how to streamline the login process for your members and ensure a seamless user experience. Let's get started. First, let's enable the social login feature. Navigate to your WordPress admin dashboard. Go to BuddyBoss, Settings, General, Registration, and enable the checkbox for social login. Once enabled, you'll see options to configure Apple Social Login. Keep this tab open, as we'll need to copy and paste some information later. On another tab, navigate to your Apple Developer account at developer.apple.com/account and log in with your credentials. First, locate your membership details and copy your team ID. Save it as we will need it later. Next, under Certificates, IDs and Profiles, click on Identifiers. Select the identifier that is linked to your app. This is the identifier you created when you first configured your iOS app. Make sure that the sign in with Apple is enabled. If not, enable it then click Save. If you haven't created an identifier yet, click the plus button. Select App ID, then click Continue. Make sure app is selected as the type, then click Continue again. Add a description and enter a unique bundle ID. Apple recommends using your domain name in reverse to ensure it's unique and not already in use. Under Capabilities, enable Sign In with Apple. Click Continue, then click Register. Next, go back to the All Identifiers page. From the left menu, click the Keys tab, then hit the blue plus icon. Enter a name for your key. Check Sign In with Apple and click Configure. Choose your primary app ID from the drop-down and click Save, then Register. Copy your key, then click Download for your private key and make sure to store it securely, as you will not be able to download it again from your Apple Developer account. Losing this file may require you to create a new key, which can disrupt app functionality. Consider backing it up in a secure location for future use. Navigate back to the Identifiers page and click the blue plus icon again. This time, select Services IDs, then click Continue. Enter a description for this service ID and enter an identifier. Click Continue, then Register. Click on the service ID you just created. Here, check Sign In with Apple, then click Configure next to it. Select your primary app ID from the dropdown. Enter your domains and subdomains, as well as your return URLs. If you're unsure about your site's return URL, you can find it in the Apple pop-up we viewed earlier. Look for the line labeled Redirect URL. Click Next. Then Save. Copy the service identifier. At this point, we can now proceed in configuring our Apple Social Login. I'm back in my WordPress admin under BuddyBoss, Settings, General, Registration. Click the pencil icon next to Apple, and we now need to fill out these fields here. This is the key ID that we copied earlier. For the private key, open the file you downloaded and copy all of its content. Lastly, enter your team and service identifier, then click Save Changes. A pop-up will appear. Sign into your Apple account to verify the settings. If you encounter errors like the username field is empty or the password field is empty, try opening your site in an incognito window and authenticate again. You can now enable Apple Social Login and click Save Settings. If the Apple Social Login checkbox remains grayed out, click the pencil icon and select Verify Settings again. For the BuddyBoss app customers, navigate to BuddyBoss app, Build. Request a new build to ensure that all recent changes are fully implemented and reflected in your app. And that's it. You've successfully set up Apple Social Login for your BuddyBoss web and app. Test the login functionality to ensure everything is working smoothly. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a like and subscribe for more BuddyBoss tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.